Thank you, Anas Cancorlia. Thank you to all deputies for their contributions this evening. Although I cannot support the motion as proposed by Sinn Féin, I do think that we agree on a number of important issues. I think the vast majority of us agree that this is not just an issue that impacts on a certain area within Dublin. This is an issue that we have seen impacting communities in towns, villages, and indeed in our rural communities as well. And I can attest to that as somebody who represents a constituency that's very rural and urban. I think that we can all agree as well that fireworks present much more dangers than people seem to realise, and in particular our younger people, who really don't seem to realise the significant threat that they can cause, and they can be life-altering threats as well. And we've heard from deputies this evening some incidents that have only happened in the last 24 hours. I think we all agree as well the illegal use of fireworks, and in particular the associated antisocial behaviour that comes with it, is causing a huge amount of stress and anxiety across our communities much earlier than usual for some reason. And what I would say is that this is something that we are seeing happening not just in Ireland but across Europe as well. There is an increase, and we have seen these type of behaviours happening much earlier this year. That is why my department, and that's why I today, with members of An Garda Síochána, with the Dublin Fire Brigade, with Anne Losty, who is a member of the community out in Dublin 15 and a youth diversion programme, we launched the government's annual fireworks awareness campaign, and this was done a month early, again taking into account and acknowledging the fact that this is an issue we need to be dealing with now. Through that campaign, we are asking people, anyone who is thinking of buying, of handling or using fireworks, to please not add to the significant problems that we are already faced, that our emergency services, that our frontline workers are already faced with, particularly in battling COVID-19. We're also asking people, as many deputies have outlined this evening, to think about the impact that this is having on their communities, whether it's members of the community who have rallied around together in recent months, elderly members of our community who are already anxious, the impact that that can have on them, the impact, as many have said, it has on their pets, and the distress that that causes to their owners as well. We're asking people to think of the impacts. Intensive efforts will be used and to try and spread this message in the coming weeks, in particular coming up to Halloween, to try and encourage people to stay safe. On Garda Síochána, many people have mentioned this evening, in particular Operation Tombola. They have brought this forward a month, again acknowledging that there is work that needs to be done earlier this year. It very much focuses on the incremental deployment of resources. This includes public order units to try and deal with issues locally, engaging with local councils, engaging with local communities. And I think some deputies mentioned maybe lack of engagement with younger people. There has been a challenge this year, and it was acknowledged by the Gardaí this morning that they couldn't go into schools, they can't talk face to face with young people as they would normally like to. But as of Monday next week, there will be a Zoom programme where they will engage. It's not the same, we all acknowledge that, but they are trying to engage where possible with our younger people in schools to really highlight the damage that this can cause, and to try and encourage them to move away from engaging in any kind of activity. Special attention in particular will be paid in the Dublin metropolitan region, and that is acknowledging that it is a particular issue in this area, and I'm informed that throughout the region there will be a huge effort between An Garda Síochána, Dublin Fire Brigade and the Crime Prevention Officers to raise awareness as well. I would share the views, I think, of everybody in this House that the use of illegal fireworks, despite the extreme policy that exists, continues to be a specific problem in certain areas. However, I want to be absolutely clear that we are absolutely committed to ensuring that Ireland and our towns, our villages, our communities, that it is a safe place to live. The well-being of all of our communities is a particular priority for us in government, but also for our younger people. And just maybe to acknowledge, we have an antisocial behaviour committee which is being established, will be chaired by my colleague Minister James Brown. We also had a draft youth justice strategy which was recently put out for consultation. Submissions were received from right across the country, and that's something that we will take into account and assess and bring this strategy to government before the end of the year. So there is a huge amount of work from my own department. Obviously Minister O'Gorman, as Minister for Children, will do his own work in that area as well. We are absolutely committed to combating the use of unlicensed fireworks. The legislation that is there governing this is particularly strict. There is a penalty of up to €10,000 or imprisonment of 5 years if people are caught. And having engaged with the Garda Commissioner on this very issue this week, there have been quite a large number of seizures if you compare it to previous years already this year, so I can only assume that that number will continue to increase. The Gardaí are engaging in a huge way with the PSNI. Their cooperation goes across a number of areas, and this is where people have asked about how we can prevent the selling of it and where young people are getting it in the first place. There's a huge amount of measures, including a cross-border policing strategy, an annual cross-border seminar on organised crime, the Joint Agency Task Force, which was just mentioned by one of the deputies. It doesn't meet on a monthly basis, but it will be meeting in the coming days, and this issue will be very much on the agenda. But also you have parallel investigations and joint investigation teams that happen constantly and continuously throughout the year. So there is significant engagement by the Gardaí with their counterparts in the north to try and address this issue. In terms of the broader policing issues, and a number of deputies have raised this and a suggestion that the resources are not there, firstly I want to acknowledge the fantastic work that has been done by our Gardaí in actually engaging with our communities through COVID and in the last number of weeks and months. We are actually being held up, and I think a lot of other countries are looking to us because of the way that our Gardaí have engaged on the ground with our communities. But if we look at the overall figures, and I'm not sure where the figures that were put into this memo by Sinn Féin came from, but in addition to the 4,059 Gardaí assigned to the Dublin metropolitan region at the end of August 2020, 429 Garda civilian staff were also assigned to this region. This is an increase of 184 on the figure in 2010. So there has been an increase in every single county across the board of frontline Gardaí working in our communities, supporting people and the civilian staff that are supporting them in the background as well. I'll pass over to my deputies. Thank you.